Now, what is riba? The riba is, example, you give 1,000, when he returned to you, you get 1,100. This 100 peso is riba. Haram. It's a very, very big sin. It's a major sin. Kabair. You borrow 5,000, then you pay 6,000. That's haram. Riba. If you will do it, Allah will angry to you and Allah will not solve your problem. Your problem will multiply. So when you lend the money, you get back same money. Then if you will not stop it, if you will not do it, to give up the riba, then take the notice of war from Allah in His messenger. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الذي نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا ومن يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وقال الله تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وذروا ما بقي من الربا إن كنتم مؤمنين فإن لم تفعلوا فأذنوا بحرب من الله ورسوله وقال الله تعالى ولا تبخسوا الناس أشياءهم ولا تعثوا في الأرض مفسدين Yesterday I made Juma khutbah in Golden Mosque and my topic was more or less the same but I will add today about riba which is the greatest sin which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Consider it as like you are making war with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you are dealing in the riba, Allah said, فَإِلَّمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبِ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ If you will not stop dealing in riba, then Allah said, I have a war with you and my messenger. You are taking the war with Allah and His messenger. And today, all the Muslim countries, They are dealing in riba, every Muslim country. They have conventional banks, which is like Citibank or Standard Chartered Bank, or other commercial conventional banks. And very sad to say that there are some new banking system in the Muslim countries, which called Islamic banks. But if you study them, If you study the Islamic bank, they are almost same. The products have a different names like Murabaha, Mudariba, Musharika, but actually the same things. But what was my topic yesterday in Quiapo, in Golden Mosque? It was about the currency. How this currency come in the existence and how this currency is making us fool in the world today. The currency, the notes, yumpera, the papel, it's not the true money. The true money is the gold and silver. Gold and silver, the coins, the real gold, the real silver. But the gold and silver coins were changed to money, the paper money. And because of the paper money, that we Muslims and also many non-Muslims, they become enslaved. They become slaves. Because your money is always depreciating. I was giving the example yesterday when Pakistan was independent, 1947. $1 was 1 rupee. $1, 1 rupee. When Philippines was independent from America, from USA, 1946, 4 July, $1, 2 peso. $1, 2 peso. So Pakistan, 1947, $1, 1 rupee. Today, $1, 160 rupee. Loss. Every day you lost. Every day you lost. Your money is always going down. Because it's not the real money. That's controlled money. The money which is manipulated by the people. The money which is controlled by some people to make you always poor. That's why you have to go abroad to work. Philippines, how much is 1 peso today? 1946, $1, $1, 2 peso. Today, $1, 48 pesos. Subhanallah. When a nurse working in the Philippines, she will get 10,000, 15,000 peso. When she work in America, she get $10,000. Why injustice? Why injustice? Why you get less here? Why you get less in Pakistan? Why you get less in India? Why you get less in Bangladesh? Why you get less in Turkey? But when you go to America, you get high pay. When you go to Europe, you get the high pay because of the paper money. In the history, no such thing. If you can compute it, for example, not only the peso to dollar or the rupee to dollar or any currency like Turkish lira to dollar, we are losing every day. Lagi tayo talo, always depreciate, always devalue. We can never get out of this poverty, the Muslim countries and also the non-Muslim countries like Zimbabwe, like Philippines, like Venezuela, Africa, old Africa. I was saying yesterday in the khutbah, the corona, the people die is 1.8 million only. 1.8 million people die with corona in 2020, in 1 year. But in 2020, the people die with the hunger, yung gutom, 11.2 million. Yung patay sa gutom, especially in Africa. 1.8 million corona, but the patay hungry, the people die with the hunger, patay sa gutom, 11.2 million. Subhanallah. What is 1.8 million corona compared to 11.2 million people died with hunger? And 12 million people died with cancer. The millions of people are dying every year because they cannot eat. Why they cannot eat? There is enough food in the world. Allah makes so many food. Rice, the wheat, the animals, the corn. So many food. But because of the money, the people get less because of their money is weak. So they cannot buy their food. Because of the money. I was saying yesterday in the khutbah, in Pakistan, $1 is 1 rupee in 1947, when Pakistan gets independence from British, $1, 1 rupee, and 1 rupee, you can buy around, more than 1 rupee, you can buy 1 gram of gold. So 1,000 rupee, 1,000 rupees, you can buy 1 kilo gold. How much is 1 kilogram gold today in Pakistan? 10 million rupees. In 1947, 1,000 rupees, one kilogram of gold. More than 1,000 rupees. Today, 10 million rupees. Today, the 10 million rupees, 1 kilogram of gold. So example, if you have a 1,000 rupee in 1947, and now you get old and you bring out, you can buy only chicken. 1,000 rupees, you can buy only 2 chicken. The native chicken. For example, in Philippines, in 1946, July 4, independence from USA, $1 is 2 peso. Today, $1 is 48 pesos. 2,400% depreciate. If 2 peso mugging 4 pesos, that's 100%. If 2 peso mugging 48, you lost 2,400% of your money. You are devalued for 2,400%. And in 1946, when Philippines was independent, 1 gram of gold was 2.2 peso. 2,200 pesos, you can buy 1 kilo of gold. How much is 1 kilo gold today? 3 million pesos. In 1946, 1 kilo gold, 2,200 pesos, 1946. Today, 1 kilogram gold is 3 million pesos. So your 2,200 pesos has no value today. On 1946, you can buy a house, 2,200 pesos. Today, you cannot buy even Kubo, 2,200 pesos. So, something big problem here. We as a world, all the people of the world, especially the Muslims and other people who are getting abused, we speak about this. We want to change the system. We want the real economy, which can be equality, which has a link to the gold. I'm going to speak about how this money was formed and how it was out from the gold now. There is no relation with the gold. It's a fiat currency without any link to the gold. And that is the reason the people in the Philippines are poor, people in Pakistan are poor, people in Bangladesh are poor, people in Turkey are poor. Most of the people in the country are very poor. Nearly 1 billion people in the world are malnourished. more than 800 million people are malnourished. And more than 1,700 million, 1.7 billion people are obese, overweight, eating too much. So people are getting hunger. People have no access to the water. People are homeless all around the world, especially in Africa. They have no house to live. Why? Because of the money is not just. That's why Allah said in the Quran, وَلَا تَبْخَسُ النَّاسَ أَشْيَاءَهُمْ. Do not reduce the things of the people. People were reducing the timbang and sukat, but today now they are reducing the money power, the value of the money. And the other topic for today is about the riba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَذَرُوا مَا بَقِيَ مِنَ الرِّبَا إِن كُنتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. O you who believe, give up the riba if you fear Allah. Give up the riba if you fear Allah. And Allah said in the next verse, فَإِن لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا فَأَذَنُوا بِحَرْبٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ. Then if you will not stop it, if you will not do it, to give up the riba, then take the notice of war from Allah and His Messenger. Now what is riba? The riba is, you give somebody the money, 1 peso or 100 pesos, 1,000 pesos, 1 million pesos, any amount. When he returns to you, you get more money. Example, you give 1,000, when he returns to you, you get 1,100. This 100 peso is riba, haram. It's a very, very big sin. It's a major sin, kabair. So when you lend the money, you get back same money. If you're going, you have a problem and you go to the pawn shop and you borrow the money from the pawn shop, that's haram, bawal. Because you give some collateral, you give some gold and they give you the money, then they charge you the interest. It's a very big sin. If you have a problem and if you have no money and you need money, don't go to the pawn shop. Don't borrow money from the interest. Don't go to the bank to borrow the money. What you do when you have a problem? Pray 2 rakat salatul hajat. Pray 2 rakat. And now you say, Allah, I have a problem. I want to solve my problem. I need money. Then Allah will provide you. Allah will make the way for you. You pray, you make 2 rakat salah, you make dua, then you go out, then Allah will help you. But do not go for the option of lending the money on riba. That's a very big sin. And Allah consider it like you are making the war with Allah's Messenger. Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the one dirham of riba, you earn, you give somebody 10,000, then he give you 100 peso riba. So one dirham is like 1 peso, for example. So you, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, if you earn 1 dirham of riba, it is like you committed 36 times zina. You committed zina, the haram, the fornication. You committed 36 times zina, 1 dirham of riba. So if you earn 1,000 peso, you committed 33,600 times zina. Because one is equal to three. Sir. If you earn 1,000 pesos for riba, you committed 36,000 times zina. That's the sin of the riba. So never try to lend the money from borrow the money from the bank, because they'll charge you interest. You need a car, you don't have the money. So what we people, Muslim, do here, for example, they go to the bank, they get the loan from the bank. And then they will pay to the riba to the bank every month, they pay installment. So what they are doing now? They are making war with Allah. And they pay interest, and when they cannot pay the installment, what the bank will do? They will get your car and they will auction it. They will sell it. There's some Muslim, they go to the bank, they get the house on the riba. They get the house on riba, they pay some down payment, and they let the bank to the pay to the house, and they pay installment to the bank. And the bank charge you 24% interest, 12% interest, 15% interest, and you pay interest every month. Subhanallah, if you die in this condition, san ka papunta impirno. Because you are making war with Allah and His Messenger. Why don't you just buy a small house? No need to buy a big house. Just buy the small house, buy on cash. Don't borrow the money from the bank. If you want to buy the car, you don't have enough money, don't go to the bank, but just buy a cheap car. Because this world is for sacrifice. This world is for making Allah happy. not to commit what Allah make haram, not to do what Allah make forbidden. If you have a small money, okay, 100,000 you have only. Just buy a second-hand car. Don't borrow the money from the bank because it's haram. Just buy a small car, cheap car, second-hand car. Then when Allah give you more money, you buy a new car. But what you do, what a Muslim doing? He has 100,000, he go to the bank, he pay 100,000, then he borrow the money from the bank, he buy the car 1 million. But to the bank, he pay 2 million, subhanAllah. And he earn money, all the money go to the bank. Every month he earn money, he pay to the bank. Now he need more money. His business is problem. He borrow more money from the bank, and then he put the house document to the car, he put everything in the bank, then everything will be taken by the bank. After that, you become zero. And in the next life, sa kabilang buhay, papunta ka sa impyerno. What is better? Do not borrow the money from the bank. Just buy a cheap car. If you cannot buy the car, just buy a motorcycle. If you cannot buy, if you have no money, small, very small money, you cannot even buy motorcycle. You cannot buy a cheap car, second-hand car. Don't buy the car. Just go in a jeep. Allah will bless you. But never do the things which Allah destroys you. Subhanallah, you buy the car from the riba, from the bank loan, you make Allah angry with you. If you're going in the car, Allah will crash this car. Allah will destroy you in this car. Allah will punish you with this car. So remember this, it is very big problem. I can see here, many Muslims, they borrow the money for the car, they borrow money for the house from the bank, they don't mind it. Why they want to buy new car? Bakit? Bakit na gusto niya bibili bagong car kahit walang pera baro sa banko? Bakit? What is the problem? Why he want to buy a new brand new car? Why? Mayabang. So you can say, I have a new car. I have a brand new car. Expensive car. SUV. Pajero. Land Cruiser. If you have no money, don't make Allah angry to borrow the money from the bank because there's a deception. There's a trap. You will keep on paying the riba. Until then, you become zero. Allah will make you bankrupt. So never go for this option. If you have no money to buy the house, don't buy the house from the bank. Just rent the house. Just buy a small house. But if you go and loan from the bank, it is a big destruction for you. Allah will be very, very angry for you because Allah said it like making war with Allah. So think of that. Remember this. Riba is haram. Never borrow the money from the bank. Never go to the pawn shop. Never borrow money from anybody. Some people, like some businessmen, if they need money, they check discount. They bring the check, they give to some rich person, even Muslim, and he will discount the check, subhanAllah. He will make riba. And you give him the commission, you give him the riba from this check. That's haram. So these are the very critical things, very, very critical things. If you are doing a riba, Allah will not accept your salah. Allah will not accept your fasting. Allah will not accept your zakat. And if you go to the hajj, Allah will not accept your hajj also. Because Allah is very angry. Allah did not say, if you drink alcohol, I will make war with you. If Allah did not say, if you play gambling, I will war with you. But Allah said in the Quran, if you make deal in the riba, then Allah make war with you. So it's a very common thing. I have some Muslim friends here, and I say, he told me that many Muslims are borrowing the money from the bank to buy the car, to buy the house, and they keep on paying the interest. So if anybody you know that they are dealing in the riba with the bank, tell them to stop it. Surrender your car. Give it back to the bank. And get back your whatever money is left there, you just get it. And just buy a second-hand car. So these are the very important things about the topic of riba. Very important thing. I hope that Ustad Bayan can explain it in Tagalog, this topic of riba, because it's a very major sin. It's a more bigger sin than many major sins. It's one of the great major sins to dealing in riba, to give the loan on interest, to borrow the loan on interest. And then Allah, the Prophet Muhammad said in the hadith The four kind of people he mentioned, four kind of people. Apadnang klasing tao. He said, the one who take the riba, the interest, the one who pay the riba, the interest, the one who is writing down the contract of the riba, and the two witness. The Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, they all will go to hellfire. So if you're working in a bank company, you are also writing the contract of the riba, interest. You are also going to hellfire. Your income is haram. The people are too much worried about the halal food. Okay, I need to buy halal chicken, I need to buy halal beef, I need to buy halal karabao. But they are not forget about the halal income. Example, you want to buy halal chicken, but your income is haram, you are making knockout. So you buy the chicken halal, but it's still haram because your income is haram. So not enough that you buy halal food, but your income should be halal. If you buy the, you have an income for the money, be cheating people, lying people, your income is haram. If you're lending money to the people and you earn riba, interest, your income is haram. So what is the best thing you do? Your income should be halal. What the Prophet Muhammad explained us? Kung hanap buhay mo haram, if your income is haram, and then you buy the food with this haram income, this food will be haram for you also. When you eat this haram food, the body will grow, will be haram also. And the haram body will not go to paradise, will go to hellfire. So there's a very important thing that our income should be halal. We should not deal in riba. We should not deal in the any business which is cheating or any business which is deception or lying or stealing or any other thing. Some people are, subhanallah, they go and they buy the gambling. They buy the loto, sweepstakes. What is it? Haram. Because there's gambling. Even if you earn the loto or you earn from the sweepstakes, the lottery, your income is haram. You eat this food, Allah will not accept your salah. Allah will not accept your fasting. Many Muslims, they go to the loto, they buy, and they lost their money. A Muslim should not go and buy loto because it's haram. And even if you win, you lost your money, and even you win the loto, still your income is haram. So rather than you waste your money in the loto, use your money for your business, halal business. Then pray to Allah and make Allah will barakah for you. So I hope that this topic can be explained in Tagalog by Ustad maybe next time, or maybe even if now there is a time, you can explain it in Tagalog, because I cannot speak everything in Tagalog. And what is my remaining issue now here is about how this money come to the existence. In the old time, yung matagal na panahon, old time, the money was not paper. There was no paper money in the world. Our ancestor before, they don't use the paper money. They use the coin, gold coin, silver coin. And there was no problem. Even you keep the money, the gold and silver, even you keep it for 100 years, 200 years, 500 years, 1,000 years, the money will not be lost. Money will not be devalued. The money will not lose the power. Not like the rupees or peso, the paper currency, the paper money. It's always lose the value. They call it inflation, but it's not inflation. That is destruction. You lose your money every day. You keep in the money in the vault, and after 40 years, you bring out no value. Before, there was a time in the Philippines, you can buy one sack of rice, 7 pesos. And not 50 kilo, 60 kilo, one sack of rice. Today, you cannot buy 1 kilo. So your money is devalued every day. You earn money with hard work, and you keep it, and then it will be finished. So old time before, there was no paper money, but the real money, the gold and silver. There was a time in UK, in England, they make the money, exchange with the gold, and they started to earn the interest. They give the paper and they say, okay, you borrow this paper and you pay us interest. And then the same money was, the paper money was given by the British to the countries like Pakistan, like India or other countries or the Europe and America. They give this when they give when making the independence, they give a different paper currency. Like in the Philippines was given the peso. And during that time, the rate of the gold was $35 per ounce. $35 per ounce. But today the rate of the dollar, the gold is $1,900 per ounce. Or $61,000 per kilo. Like almost 3 million pesos for 1 kilo. So the United States of America, they give the, they get all the gold from the people in USA and they give them the paper note, the $20 note. They get $20 per ounce. And after some time, they devalue the dollar. They make it one ounce, $35. So $35 per ounce. And then since the time, the 1944 during the World War II, they make that only dollar can travel to the world. So people agreed. And they said, we will return the gold whenever you want to get back your gold. But in 1973, the American government, they refused to change dollar to gold. And since that time, the dollar has no link to the gold. Nothing. It's a free floating currency without the link to the gold. So gold was started to increase from that time. $35, and then it became $40, then $400, $800, $1,200, $1,600. Today, nearly $2,000 per ounce, or $61,000 per kilogram. And that's how the money was controlled by the in the world. And that is the reason that the people are very poor, like in Philippines or in Pakistan or in these countries has low value money. But in Europe and America, they have high value money. They said they go there to become slave, so they can earn the high money, the high value of money. Like Zimbabwe, when they speak against the injustice, their money was devalued in Zimbabwe, African country. Not even a Muslim country. Robert Mugabe, the president, when he speak against the injustice, their money was devalued. Until the $1 of US dollar become 250 million Zimbabwe dollar. One US dollar equal to 250 million Zimbabwe dollar. So that's all is how the people in the world become poor. Now most of the people in the world poor because of this interest system, this riba system, this monetary system. What is the solution? We all the Muslims in the world, we demand to bring back the link to the money. The paper money should have a link with the gold. And the gold rate should be fixed. What is the rate of gold today? $1,900 per ounce. If it will be fixed, no fluctuation, then we can stop the inflation. As long as the dollar to the gold or the peso to the gold or rupees to the gold is fixed. Fixed as today, $1,900 per ounce. Okay, no changing of the gold rate. Then our money will be stable. That is my solution for the world, which we can talk to the other people and other people, and until it reaches to everybody in the world that we need to make fix the gold rate. Gold rate will not change. Fix $1,900 per ounce. And when it will apply in the world, slowly by slowly, the money will not lose the value. The people will not get poor with the, because of the money. So that is the solution here. Now it's 6:26 here. I can get some question answers. If anybody want to question to me, I can answer and I can continue to speak. Also, what time is Azan? Did you call the Yatim for? Okay, inshallah. Only few. Okay. But more people better we have, inshallah. Okay, inshallah. So anybody has a question about the topic?
I have some questions.
Okay.
My question is, yes, we believe that the problem of riba as of today. And my question is, how could we eliminate this riba? For example, during the time of the time of the one of the big organization Muslim in Lanao. They're trying their best to eliminate the riba, to have a good transaction.
Mm.
But the problem today is this riba, for example, this 5-6.
Yeah, haram.
Haram. Most of the people giving 5-6 from India.
Yes, yes, haram.
Everywhere here. How could we eliminate this? For example, if there are Muslims who will be a philanthropist, for example, sir, they could be coming to organize themselves and give a transaction. They can give credit without interest.
Interest, yeah.
For example, in Marawi, in Markasu Sabab, they have a pawn shop. And this pawn shop, they can give you a credit, but you have to a security, which is no interest at all.
Oh, good.
Service.
No interest.
Yes. Can we do it possibly?
Okay. There's a very good question here, and I can also add about the 5-6, no? Because our brother said Marami 5-6 here in Taguig, in Marlika. So that's haram. If you borrow the money from the 5-6 Indian, you borrow 5,000, then you pay 6,000. That's haram, riba. If you will do it, Allah will angry to you, and Allah will not solve your problem. Your problem will multiply. Your problem will be dagdag yung problem mo. The first thing kung may kailangan mo, the first thing, if you have a problem, the first thing, only Allah can remove the problem. You make 2 rakat salatul haja, dalawang rakat salah. Make ablution, wazu, pray 2 rakat, and then pray to Allah, Allah solve my problem. The first thing, you pray to Allah, Allah solve my problem. And then you go to the good people. Rather than you borrow the money from the 5-6, haram, riba, you go to the your Muslim brothers, rich or not rich. You go to the many Muslims and tell, okay, you give me little, and then you can complete your need for your hospital or for other things. That's one thing. And right thing also that there should be the philanthropist, no? Some people who are helping also. And it's also good thing that somebody can make a shop and they get the gold. And they give the loan. And then if they cannot pay back, then he has a gold, okay? Correct? Gold or any valuable. Especially the gold, okay? So he get the gold and he keep the gold. And when he come back, he return the gold. But if he cannot come back, he can just sell the gold to get his money. Yung sobra, he will give it to him. Yeah, because that's also the way that a Muslim can open the gold shop. Because if you invest in the gold, it's a good for you also. You keep on buying the gold. Like some people, they can pay you back. Okay, you return the gold. If they cannot pay you back, you sell the gold and you give them the excess money. The another good thing also, that the Muslim community like Marlika, they can implement is Palwagan. Okay, that's also option, Palwagan. You know Palwagan?
Yes.
Okay, 10 people, they collect money, 100 every month, 1,000 every month. And then 10,000, you give to one person this month. Next month, you give to another person. Next month, you give to third person. Whoever need more, you give it this 10,000. That's also another option. Example, 100 people. And 100 people, they collect 1,000 in Marlika. And you have a 1 month 100,000 collection. And now you have 100 people, you get the raffle. Okay, who will get this 100,000 today, this month? Okay, you get it. Or somebody has a emergency operation, okay, you get 100,000 this month. That's a very good system. We know this kind of system also applicable in Pakistan also. We call it BC, but here they call it Palwagan, okay? So that's also option. You can gather monthly money, 10 people, 100 people, 1,000 people, and then you make raffle or you give it to the person who need it. So example, if you have 100,000 without interest already, you built your house, you spend for your house. And then you pay the collection, the Palwagan every month to complete your obligation. That's another option. There are many options, of course. And those who are rich, they should read in the Quran that Allah said, "Man zalladhi yaqrudu Allah qardan hasana." That who can give the loan to Allah means for Allah. So when you're giving the loan, without interest, it's a great reward. It's a great reward. So giving loan without interest, Allah will bless you and Allah will multiply your wealth. And Allah will give you more in the, Allah will give you the blessings in the next life. So there are many options which people can choose to get rid of this riba. For me, a kind of riba, maybe many Muslims, many people will not agree. Some people even fight with me about this. I said, example, if you're selling something, Alimbawa, you sell a cell phone. And you say to the person, I'm selling this cell phone, 50,000. 50,000, I sell this cell phone. But the person said, I cannot pay you right now. I don't have the 50,000. I'll pay you in 2 months. And he will say, okay, not 50,000, you pay 60,000. Because you pay in 2 months. For me, that's also riba. This haram. But many Muslims do this. If you buy at mokash, mababa yung presyo. Kung buy at credit, mataas yung presyo. That's also financing. There's a kind of riba also, because if the person is paying you cash, 50,000, but if he pay you in 2 months, you charge 60,000. For me, that's riba, because 10,000 you are getting more because he pay you after 2 months. But many people are not saying it riba. Many scholars, they don't say this riba, but it's like riba. It's like technical riba. You are hiding the riba. So that's explanation here for your question. So the solutions I give, one of the solutions is also to the rich people should give the credit without interest. Like you said that in Marawi there is a pawn shop or the shop which giving the free from interest. Yeah, it's a good thing. And he's safe also because he get the collateral. Like the Prophet Muhammad sallam, he showed in this example, before he died, he give his armor to a Yahudi and he borrowed the money from him. So he give his armor and he borrowed the money from the Yahudi on loan. And it was without interest also. So it's a good option also that somebody can make a shop, a rich person. And he just put 2-3 million there helping people. He get collateral, help people, and then they return in the money. And then he can loan to the more people. So he is helping with his money. Because one of the masraf of the zakat is also to pay for the qarz. Example, you have a qarz, you have a debt, and you cannot pay and you are worried you might die. So you will ask somebody to give you zakat to pay your debt. It's allowed also in Islam. Okay? For to paying the debt, you are allowed to get zakat also. So example, if the person opens lending without interest using zakat money, it's also okay. He used the zakat money to lend people who are in need. Not for the financial, for business, not for the business, but helping to the poor with the loan without interest. It could be used also, zakat money, not for the investment for the shop or for the business, but just for the needy people, those who are mahirap and they need money for their emergency or for some emergency needs, then you can give the zakat money. If they pay you back, give it to the others. If they don't pay you back, forgive them because it's also zakat. So that's also another option. So any question here, inshallah? The Prophet Muhammad ﷺ mentioned a different kind of riba. One of kind of riba, he said, if a person is coming from the field, from the plantation, he brings some product to sell it in the market, you stop him on the highway and you buy from him. And you did not tell him how much the price in the market. And the Prophet Muhammad said, that's also riba. Because you are hiding from him. So deception, the money earned with the deception is also riba. So you're not telling that how much this fruit in the example. Somebody coming from Pampanga, Dadalinya, you mango, and you stop him on the NLEX, in the highway, and you tell him, sell to me your truck. And you are not telling how much in Divisoria. You just buy it on the highway. And you are hiding from him the price in Divisoria. The Prophet Muhammad said, that's also riba. Because you are getting benefit from him. You don't want him to go to the market to get the real price. So these are the different kind of riba. And there's a big curse for the people to deal in the riba. And not to deal in the riba is a blessing. As I said, that many people are borrowing the money and they get the house on the riba, interest from the bank. they get the car on the riba, also the credit card. Many Muslims, they have a credit card. They pay through the credit card and it's also riba because they charge you the interest. And if you pay before that, before a 1 month, then they will still collect the interest from the seller. Because the bank always, the Visa, the MasterCard, they always collect the interest. So rather than you can get the credit card, don't get the credit card, you get the debit card. Because debit card is your own money. And some people, they want to open the account in the bank. When you open the account in the bank, you should open the checking account or the current account, not the savings account. Because if you open the savings account, you will earn the interest. And interest is a very big sin. So example, if you have no choice and you really need a bank account for your business, you still ask Allah to forgive you, because even you put the money in the current account, the bank will use it for interest business. So you will still get the sin. But if you have no choice and you're doing it, then never open the savings account in the bank. You must open the checking account or the current account. So there will be no interest earning in your account. But if you open the savings account, then you will earn the interest also. So that will be a big problem also. So inshallah, what is the, is it still time here? Okay, 10 minutes more. Okay.
Another question.
Okay, inshallah.
With regards to this online selling, is this halal or halal?
Okay, online selling is not the problem, but when you pay the online selling, you must pay debit card, not the credit card. Because credit card is riba. So debit card like BDO or BPI, debit card or ATM card, you can pay. But sometimes the online selling accepting COD, no problem COD. But if you pay the credit card, that's a big problem. You can pay through GCash, you can pay through other like PayPal, PayMaya or debit card is okay. But the best is COD. Because some online selling, they accept the COD. But do not use the credit card. Because if you pay the online selling credit card, that's also haram. Because credit card, you borrow the money from the bank. So that's also a big problem for us to deal with. And I can add one about the Islamic banking. Are you aware of Islamic banking? In Philippines, there is one Islamic bank, Amana. Okay, I study about the Islamic bank. Islamic bank is same like the conventional bank. Nothing different. Just the name of the change. Okay? For example, if you drink alcohol, alak, and you say it's haram, you are Muslim, correct? Because you believe that's haram. But if you drink the alak, and you say, oh, that's a drink only, and it's not halal. It's not haram, it's halal. So you make alak, the alcohol, halal. So it's a big problem. What the Islamic bank is doing, I can give you the one example, the Murabaha. Even though many scholars, they give fatwa in Middle East, in also in Pakistan, and in other countries, they give fatwa that Islamic bank is halal. But what is Islamic bank? Islamic bank is same like a conventional bank. Like example, you want to buy a house. So you go to the bank, and bank buy the house for you, and they keep the mortgage, the documents they keep in the bank. And you pay interest, 24%, 12%, 30%, and you pay monthly interest with the actual amount. When you pay the full amount, the bank will give you the documents, the title. But if you fail to pay full amount, the bank will get your house and they will auction, correct? That is how the banks work. What the Islamic bank does? The Islamic bank will also buy the house for you, and they will tell you that this house is 5 million, they buy from the developer. But if you tell you pay in 10 years, the Islamic bank say, I will sell you 10 million. Why 10 million? Why 5 million house you sell 10 million? Because you pay me little by little. So it's same, nothing different. And the Islamic bank also is keeping your document, the mortgage. So it's the same thing. The Islamic bank is also deception. It's not different, but it's same like riba, exactly riba, but they don't call it riba. They call it Islamic, nauzubillah. So I can encourage people to learn about the topic. Alhamdulillah, there is no much banks Islamic here, because the Islamic bank is not Islamic, but it's cheating. They call it Islamic bank, but they are not Islamic. They are just like the other banks, but they change the name, which is called Murabaha, Mudariba, Musharika. But when you study them, they are totally riba. And they actually charge more riba, like in Saudi Arabia, they have a Raji Bank. It's all riba. You go on website and check. They even put the rate, 5%, 10%, everything is there. They charge you and they pay the riba and then they charge the riba. But they don't call it, they call it halal. But it's not halal. If you have eyes to see, and if you have mind to think, and if you have ear to hear, you know that it's haram. Very clearly. Your heart will tell you that's haram. When you just go and check the website of Raji Bank, or Dubai Islamic Bank, or Mizan Bank in Pakistan, they're all dealing in riba. Like Amana Bank in Philippines, go and check what they're doing. And you will come, so you will know the same thing like other banks. And they're also dealing with the World Bank, and they're also dealing with IMF. So they are the same, but just the name is Islamic, but they are not Islamic. They are committing haram, they are committing riba. So inshallah, yeah. Only one person question, no other question. All is silent. Okay. Yes, yes.
For example, I need 1 million or 100,000.
Okay.
And you have a lot of money. So I come to you and I said, can you borrow me 100,000?
And then you give the car.
This is my house.
Or car.
Yeah, or car.
Okay.
Security.
Oh. Then you can use it.
Yeah, we make a comment.
Okay.
Afterwards, you let my house rent.
Yeah.
Is this riba or not?
Haram, riba. It's riba. This is called Sangla Tubus, correct? Yes. In Tagalog. Sangla Tubus, haram. Bawal din Sangla Tubus. Dahil, the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that if you are loaned to somebody and he give you the horse to use, the Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that's haram because you get benefit. Okay? If you give the loan to anybody, you lend the money, you cannot get any benefit. Alimbawa, you give me the house and you borrow money from me, 1 million, and I rent the house and I earn the money, haram, because I'm getting benefit from my loan. Or example, you give me the car and you borrow money from me, 100,000, and you give to him, brother, you give him the car, and then you borrow from him 100,000, and he's using your car. Then he gave you the money. He's getting benefit for the loan. So when you give the loan, walang benefits. Any benefit is considered as riba. So no benefits at all. So it becomes also haram. Like in Philippines, it's called Sangla Tubos. Okay. In like the squatter area, the house is 50,000. He borrowed the 50,000 from the brother. And he said, okay, you leave my house for 10 months or 11 months or 12 months. Don't pay me the rent anymore. Just leave for free. And until he paid, returned the money, 50,000, then he returned the house. But as long as no returned house, he will use the house for free. That's also haram. That's called Sangla Tubus. It's haram. Because the Prophet Muhammad told us, when you give the loan, no benefits. Even if you give the loan to somebody and he called you to the dinner, the Prophet Muhammad said it's haram also. Because you are getting the dinner from him. Because you give him the loan. He's giving you feeding you, he's giving you a dinner or the party because you give him the money for the loan. So you are getting benefit from him because he's giving you the benefit of the dinner. So Prophet Muhammad said, if you lend money and he invites you for the food, do not go there because it will be considered as riba also. So even the food only is also riba. If somebody rents your house and borrow money because you borrow money from them, it's also the riba and haram. Okay, inshallah. No question. So inshallah you can make dua. Yes. Yes.
My question is, overpricing considered as riba?
Okay. Overpricing, because as I said, there are many examples for the riba. Overpricing means, for example, like we are in pandemic and the mask, for example. What happened in the people? They get the benefit because now mask is very needing now, for example, the mask. So some people, they hike the price. The mask before, because we are dealing in the business of medicine, our business is medicine. Before, the mask is only 50 peso one box. How much? 50 peso one box. But when the pandemic started in the last year in like March, April, and people are needing masks, everybody buying mask. What happened now? Mask, 600 pesos, one box. 600 pesos, one box. So why? It's also riba, because you are getting benefit. Because people need something and you make it high price. So it's considered as riba also. It's like a kind of riba. For example, hoarding. I don't know, you know meaning the hoarding. The Tagalog, ano ibig sabihin na hoarding? Hoarding? H-O-A-R-D-I-N-G, hoarding. Halimbawa, the rice is shortage. Di ba? Kulang yung rice sa market. And you keep in the bodega maraming bigas. Talo, tago. And you make the padlock and then you waiting for the demand. When demand comes and you make the high price now. Before 40, now maging gawin mo 50, you keep maraming rice para matas. That's haram also and that's considered as riba also. So you are high pricing because of the need of the people. That's a very big sin and it's also riba. Like example, what happened in the vitamin C last year. When people need the vitamin C because of the pandemic, corona, the people make a high price for vitamin C. Before, how much vitamin C? Like 50 pesos, 80 pesos. But because people need the high price, 300 pesos. One box of vitamin C, making 300 pesos. So it's also considered as riba. Because you are getting the benefit of the need of the people. So do not do this. You should make the same price. You don't think that people need badly, they will buy any price, no. Sell it the same price. So you will not get the sin from Allah to selling at high price because people need it. So that's also a good question from the brother. Okay. So inshallah, yes.
One more question.
Okay, inshallah.
Last question. For example, we are brothers. We are relatives. And then we invest, for example, 1 million pesos. And every one of us is allowed to take this money for the business.
Uh-huh.
And then we make agreement after 1 month, or 3 months, or 1 year, we will return the money with excess. Not mentioning, for example, I got 100,000. And after 1 month, after my business, I return 150,000. Is that riba or not?
Yeah, it's riba because you have no loss here. Only allow the investment, like you and him. You make 500, you make 1 million and he make 1 million or 2 million. And you make business every day. And you make the cut off 1 year. So after 1 year, your 2 million mugging 1 million, lost 1 million. So he get the loss 500,000, you get the loss 500,000. Okay, no problem. But after the 1 year, your 2 million mugging 4 million. So how much the tubo? 2 million. So he get 1 million, you get 1 million. That's halal. Because you have a risk. He can get loss, you can get loss. He can get profit, you can get profit. Then that's halal. That's called the investment, okay? Example, you invest with the company 1 million. And company give you the share. But if the company lost, they give you the loss. So that's only halal in Islam. There's only financing halal in Islam when you have a profit and loss. But if it is only profit, example, you give him 1 million and he said, bahala ka na, kahit talo ka, you still pay me 100,000. That's riba. But if you make it profit and loss, that we make business, example, the farming, agriculture, rice, and comes baha, flood, and lost the rice, then you divide the loss. And if you earn 2 million, you divide the 1 million each, halal. But if loss, you divide the loss, then it's become halal, okay? So there should be the profit and loss sharing. The investment should be the profit and loss sharing, then it's halal. But if it is fixed profit, no loss sharing, making haram. So that's a rule of Islam, that the profit and loss sharing is halal. But if only profit, no, you will not accept the loss, it's riba, okay? So inna Allah malaikatu salluna ala nabiyya yu ladhina amunu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhaban nar. Ameen. Ya Allah, our Lord, give us good in this world and good in the hereafter. Save us from your anger, save us from hellfire. Ameen. Ya Allah, be happy with us and enter us in jannatu fi dos in paradise in next life forever. Ameen. Ya Allah, guide us. Ameen. Ya Allah, forgive us. Ameen. Ya Allah, mercy on us. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect us. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect us. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect us. Ameen. Ya Allah, give our, Ya Allah, protect our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, protect our children and all the children of the world and give long life. Ameen. Ya Allah, remove all sickness. Ameen. Ya Allah, save us from riba. Ameen. Ya Allah, save us from all sin. Ameen. Allah save us from kufar and shirk. Ameen. Allah be happy with us in intern to us in Jannah through Firdaus in paradise in our next life forever. Ameen. Allah save us from anger and save us from hellfire. Ameen. Allah we ask from you all good which your prophets and all good people they ask from you. Ameen. Allah we seek a protection from all the evil from which your prophets and all good people they seek a protection. Ameen. Allah accept our dua which you ask and which not ask. Ameen. Allah accept our dua which you ask and which not ask. Ameen. Allah accept our dua, she ask, nishin da task. Ameen. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna maulana innaka antat tawwabur rahim. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun alal mursalin. Alhamdulillahi bil alamin.